folks, Dagan here from PMTVUK, and today I have the absolute pleasure of showcasing for you my brand new friend, Jessica. Let's get into it. Now, if you're unfamiliar with Jessica, it's Slasher's guitar. It's Slasher's number one guitar. Well, one of his many number one guitars, but this is, I think, is world-renowned as his number one guitar. And this has just been released in the Slash lineup from Gibson, their core lineup of Slashers with all the appetites and stuff. You can now get Jessica. Now, why is Jessica so important? Why is it so revered, I hear you ask? And it's because, ladies and gentlemen, Jessica is the first Les Paul given to him by Gibson back in 1988. When Slash retired, the Appetite guitar, he had a couple of 59 replicas that said Gibson on the headstock, made by the legendary Chris Derrig. When he retired those, he asked Gibson for some guitars, and he got sent two Cherry Sunbursts. It was obviously faded into this Honey Burst we all know and now he can get. But he was given two guitars, one of them was Jessica, and he's used it pretty much solidly since 1988. Guns N' Roses stuff, Velvet Revolver stuff, and now it's back on stage with Guns N' Roses and Slash's solo tier and stuff. Jessica's got the cigarette burn there and stuff. That's Jessica. And this is a replica of that. And it's also the reason why plain top 1988 Les Paul standards cost way more than other ones. Because it's not like a 50s Les Paul or something, it's just a late 80s Les Paul standard, plain top. The reason 88s cost so much is because of Jessica. But now you haven't got to buy an original, you can get a stunning, simply stunning recreation from Gibson with Jessica. With this one, it's great. It's part of the Slash collection, obviously. But you'll notice straight away, besides just the color, it hasn't got a flame top. But it plays like an absolute dream. I'm a huge fan of the Slash lineup of Les Pauls because they are quintessentially, they're a bit more special than a regular Les Paul standard. For one reason, they've got like a 59 Chris Derrig profile neck, but I'll talk about that later. But they're just, besides the fact they look really cool, they're just fantastic guitars. You've got the Alnicos and stuff. They're just brilliant. And now, three-piece. They come with strap locks. They do come with Schaller strap locks, because Slash uses strap locks, but I haven't got them out. They're in the case, ready for you. But yeah, they come with three-piece plain maple tops. As you can see, all the flames on the Appetite Burst here, plain maple tops. And that's quite special and very unique and quintessentially Jessica. And now if you want to get one for yourself, there's a link in the description box down below which will take you to pmtonline.co.uk. You can get one for yourself. It's seriously mint. At its core, it is still, of course, your run-of-the-mill Slash signature Les Paul standard. One of the best playing and sounding Les Paul standards on the entire planet, in my humble opinion. I mean, if the recipe's perfect out of the box, why would you change it? Just put a funky top on it, three-piece plain maple, and make it look like Jessica. What's not to love? The first thing that I've ever noticed, though, which is very interesting, is the fact that the fret nibs aren't covered. So it has got the same medium jumbo frets, but they do feel a bit smaller, but it does say medium jumbo on Gibson's website. The frets aren't covered by the binding. Now, it's a common thing with Gibson, and on the other Slash guitars, where the binding goes over the frets, which means sometimes when you play the guitar, wood changes over time. It expands and contracts ever so slightly, and sometimes those little nibs can get have a little, like a little bit between them. A gap, essentially. What I'm trying to say, hopefully you can see some pictures on screen right now of the comparisons between Jessica and another regular Les Paul with the binding. So the frets go over the binding, so there's going to be no gap if anything changes in the future. You often see this when guitars get refretted as well, old Gibsons and stuff. You lose the little fret nib just for a regular fret. That's the first thing I noticed. It was very cool. It rings like a bell. No weight relief in this model. Mahogany construction, my straps came off again. I really should get those strap locks out the bag. Mahogany construction, no weight relief. Again, three-piece plain maple top, the same as Jessica, so this is quite a nice example. Right here. Honey Burst, that kind of faded Cherry Burst, because like Slash said, it was originally Cherry Burst, but it's been used so damn much. Set mahogany neck with that 50s rounded profile we all know and love so much. Finished Cluson tuners up top. You've got Slash's name on the truss rod cover, but it does come with a blank truss rod cover in the case. If you want to switch it over, you can. Because it's not overtly, besides the awesome color, it's not overtly signature, is it? It's not like a Sinister Gates model with loads of stripes on it and stuff. one of them. It is just a lovely vintage-inspired Les Paul. You've got Slasher's Scully logo on the back of the headstock. That's kind of the only other giveaway besides the truss rod cover and those lovely colours. Vintage Cluson-style tuners up top. Rosa board, 12-inch radius. Again, a very familiar Les Paul recipe. Down to the body, though, is where it gets interesting. And I say interesting as if things have actually changed. They're not. It's just the standard custom Alnico 2 Gibson Custom Burstbucker pickups. They're in all the Slash models, but they're some of the best-sounding, most articulate, dynamic, raunchy pickups on the entire planet. They're fantastic, and everyone always says, why aren't Seymour Duncan's Slasher's signature Seymour Duncan's in his signature models? Because Gibson make their own pickups and they can make their own Seymour Duncan's. They're exactly the same, but instead of them having to buy tons of Seymour Duncan's from Seymour Duncan, they just make them themselves. So that's why that's a thing. Some of the best sounding pickups on the entire planet, obviously CTS pots, Mallory capacitors, you've got an aluminium tunematic bridge and tailpiece, three-way switch up there. So Slasher's Paul. And it's great. Everything you play on it is great. Like I said, these Alnico 2 pickups are just stunning. They're just so throaty and so warm and lovely and rounded. They're great. What are the specs that I missed? That aluminium tunematic bridge I was saying before is a Nashville style. The Nashville style comes with a case, obviously all nitrocellulose lacquer. Oh, it's got a red back. Forgot to mention the red back. So Honey Burst with a red back. That's all the specs. Comment down below what you think. And like I say, if you want to get one, call into your local PMT store or click the description box down below to get one of these wonderful things for yourself. Right, let's hear some more. That's enough of yakking on. I'm not playing lots of Guns N' Roses stuff because these guitars cater to so many more folk than just Slash fans and Velvet Revolver fans and Guns fans and Slash or Snakebit fans. And everything is wonderful top hat adorned fingers I've ever touched. Guitars are for everyone, but Slash stuff just sounds so good on it. We'll be right back. really getting at that. And you know, said I wasn't gonna play any Guns N' Roses songs, but Jesus Christ, it sounds so bloody good. Let's hear some clean sounds there. Okay, maybe just a couple more Guns songs, because that sounds so damn good. Thank you. pickup sounds awesome on a clean tone. It's got the bite, but it's also got a lot of low end as well. Hopefully YouTube doesn't just compress everything here. I think, ladies and gents, that's all the sight specs and sounds I can give you from the wonderful slash signature Jessica Gibson Les Paul Standard. Let us know what you think down below in the comments, and like I say, if you want to get one for yourself, there's a link down there in the description so you can get one at PMTonline.co.uk. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and hit subscribe. You'll find us at Play Music Today on all social media platforms. You'll find me at Dagan Wilkin on Instagram. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.